Good morning, students. I am your social science teacher, Joseph Linos, going to present 10th standard first unit civics. The name of the lesson is Indian Constitution. Today, we are going to discuss about the Indian Constitution. The Constitution of India was framed by a Constituent Assembly set up under the Cabinet Mission Plan 1946. The assembly consisted of 389 members. The assembly held its first meeting on December 9, 1946. Dr. Sachidananda Sinha, the oldest member, was elected as the temporary president of the assembly. After the death of Dr. Sachidananda, Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as the president of the assembly. The assembly met for 11 sessions along with 166 days of meetings. During the discussion, 2473 amendments were presented. Some of them were accepted. The draft of the Constitution was prepared by the drafting committee under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He is recognized as the father of the Constitution of India. After the draft had been discussed by the people, the press, provincial assemblies, and others, the Constitution was finally adopted on November 26, 1949. It contained a preamble, 22 parts, 395 articles, and 8 schedules. The drafted Constitution came into force on 26th January 1950. This day is known as the Republic Day. Salient features of the Constitution of India. It is the lengthiest of all the written constitutions of the world. It was borrowed most of the provisions from the constitutions of various countries. It is partly rigid and partly flexible. It establishes a federal system of government. It makes India as a secular state. It provides an independent judiciary. It introduces universal adult franchise and accords the right to vote to all citizens above 18 years of age without any discrimination. Fundamental rights. There are 6 fundamental rights. They are right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to religion, cultural and educational rights, right to constitutional remedies. Right to equality. Article 14, equality before law. Article 15, prohibition of discrimination on grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, or place of birth. Article 16, equality of opportunity in matters of public employment. Article 17, abolition of untouchability. Article 18, abolition of titles except military and academic. Right to freedom. Article 19, freedom of speech and expression, assembly, association, movement, residence, and profession. Article 20, protection in respect of conviction for offenses. Article 21, protection of life and personal liberty. Article 21A, right to elementary education. right to Article 22, protection against arrest and detention in certain cases, right against exploitation, Article 23, prohibition of traffic in human beings and forced labor, Article 24, prohibition of employment of children in factories, etc., right to religion, Article 25, freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion. Article 26, freedom to manage religious affairs. Article 27, freedom from payment of taxes for promotion of any religion. Article 28, freedom from attending religious instruction or worship in certain educational institutions, cultural and educational rights. Article 29, protection of language, script and culture of minorities. Article 30, right of minorities to establish and administrate educational institutions, right to constitutional remedies. Article 32, it allows individuals to seek redressal for the violation of their fundamental rights, right to constitutional remedies. Article 32, a writ is an order or command issued by a court in writing under its seal. It is in the nature of a command or prohibition from performing certain acts that are specified in the orders of the court. Both the Supreme Court and the High Courts are empowered to issue five kinds of writs, such as habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, quo warranto, and certiorari. Habeas corpus safeguards people from illegal arrests. Mandamus, it protects the petitioner who requires legal help to get his work done by respective public authorities. Prohibition, it prohibits a subordinate court from acting beyond its jurisdiction. Quo warranto, it prevents usurpation of public office through illegal manner. Certiorari, it quashes an order issued by a subordinate court by overstepping its jurisdiction. Thank you.